Texas at Minute Maid Park. The show brings you the National League Wild Card Series. It's the Minnesota Twins taking on the Houston Astros. Joined by my partner, Chris Singleton, I'm John Shumby. Postseason baseball, Singy, it's always great to see and be a part of.
Oh, Boog, you just never know what's in store when it comes to postseason baseball. You do know you're going to see some amazing pitching, guys coming out of the bullpen throwing 100, some incredible defensive plays, some big knocks, and maybe a mistake or two that'll live on forever. All I do know is I'm pumped up for this one.
First pitch coming at you right after the break. Just about to get underway, and today's starting pitcher, Justin Verlander.
Try to stay back for that power changeup. Speed differential between the fastball and the changeup is huge. Hitters, they have a hard time staying back.
And at the plate, number 47. High fly ball, pretty well struck out towards right center. That's down, one hops off the wall. Round second, digging for third. And he'll get there as he kicks off the ball game with a triple.
Everything came together perfectly for him right there. I love the hustle out of the box. Man, he drove that baseball, and he was thinking triple right away. A chance now to take the lead, and at this point in the game, that could be a deciding run.
And first offering is fouled off. Runner at third here, nobody out. Line drive, base hit. And they'll score first. It's one zip.
Big RBI for him right there. Fastball pretty much middle, and that's what you fall asleep dreaming about as a hitter. So no surprise he put a great swing on it.
Here's Royce Lewis. And first offering is fouled off. Swung on. He circles the bases, his second home run of the series.
When a guy's got a real hard fastball, you can't overswing. All you gotta do is get the bat head to the spot. If you do, he supplies the power, and you'll get to jog around the bases like he did right there.
Now batting Max Kepler. First offering is fouled off.
It can be tough to bounce back after a big home run, but nobody on, nobody out. You just have to treat it as a fresh inning.
Oh, and now this one's crushed. This one's on its way. And gone. Max Kepler knocks one out, and they add a run. It's 4-0. He absolutely crushed that one.
No doubt about that one, Boog. We knew it wasn't coming back.
Chris, that ball came out hot. So let's see what StatCast has to say.
Yeah, it really did, Boog. 111 miles per hour off the bat, and a really nice launch angle as well. Just a beautiful swing from start to finish.
Here's Alex Kirilloff. Swings and sends a rocket to right. One down. And now we take a peek at the Twins lineup. Chris, this is a lineup offensively that could be really good for years to come.
They're deep, first and foremost, but the way that they can manipulate their personnel for matchups and everything else, it's very intelligent the way that they use their team. And I think it creates a little bit of uncertainty for opposing teams, especially in a big game, big series.
And that's down, a base hit. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
Well, no waiting around right there. He was ready to swing it on the first pitch. Just a cookie down the middle. I mean, those are the ones you dream about. Ones in the cage, you're just hoping you get in the ball game. Right down the middle, not a whole lot of velocity, right on top of it.
Alvarez in position. That's out number two.
With how good these offenses are, there's a lot of ball game left.
Ryan Jeffers at the plate. Thank you. Fly ball down the line. Tries to make the play, but it's foul.
Well, a really rough inning out there on the mound. And this is one of those where you learn a lot about a guy's toughness and his ability to turn the page and keep pressing forward.
That's a hit. They stop the lead runner at second. Now two on with two outs. Michael A. Taylor now at the plate. Foul back our way, and that's out of play. Chris, Justin Verlander has had a lot of notoriety since he was first drafted. Second overall pick by the Tigers in 2004 out of Old Dominion, and a guy who has won three Cy Youngs. And well, he's under to make the catch in center, and we'll take a break. But the long ball was working in this inning. Not once, but twice. It's now a 4-0 ball game. This is the National League Wild Card Series on the show. Back here in Houston, our starting pitcher in this one, Pablo Lopez.
Anytime you have five pitches to work with on the mound, that repertoire can be a real weapon in terms of keeping hitters off balance, man. It's one of those things that I'm going to be looking for in this one. Does he have a feel for all of those pitches, or is he just able to get one or two over in the strike zone where he wants? Now, it's tough to do to be able to command all those pitches, but if he can, he is going to be very tough for the opponent today.
Swing and a miss. And the count is 1-2. They've got a potent lineup, and when you think about teams capable of rallying from this kind of deficit, they're right at the top of the list. Got him looking for the strikeout. Called strike three on a fastball up in the zone. Now it's Alex Bregman in there for strike one. Packed house here at Minute Maid. Next offering is in for a strike.
He doesn't seem to like to pitch up. Hasn't offered on either one of those pitches. 0-2 count now. I think the guy's going to climb the ladder out there.
And a pop-up. Right side. Foul territory. He's got it. There's two away.
Got it.
Now we check out the Astros lineup. Now with their ace on the mound today, they're just looking to provide him a little bit of run support. They'll see what they can do for him.
You have to be really careful when you've got a guy like this on the mound for you to not become a spectator. You know that he doesn't give up a whole lot, but sometimes guys get a little too comfortable and don't have an urgency to score runs. You have to make sure you put him in a situation where he can get the W, but also you guys can cruise to the finish line and not have to worry about a comeback in the end.
The pitch. Swings and misses, struck him out. So they go quietly there. On to the second inning now from Minute Maid Park. It's the Twins 4 and the Astros nothing. Back here at the ballpark, now it's the second baseman, number 47. The wind of the pitch. Into center. Alvarez in position. Hauls it in for the out. Batter now, Jorge Polanco, singled and scored his first time. Now a screamer into the outfield. And Polanco is out. And there's two down. So up next for Minnesota, Royce Lewis. He's already homered here in this one. Swings and blasts one deep to left center. Alvarez going back on this one. Pulls it in on the warning track. Nothing doing here for the Twins, but they lead it 4-0. Fouls one off. inside corner. That's a strike. And it's 0-2. Eric Summersgill, our plate umpire.
One thing to watch out for, Boog, is what side of the plate Summersgill might be favoring. He usually sets up at an angle. Pitchers sometimes will try to figure that out early so they can attack that spot and get as many strike calls as possible.
Michael Brantley stands in. Next pitch is popped up. Kirilov in position. Makes the play, and that's out number three. Three up, three down that time. We played two full. It's the Twins four and the Astros nothing. On to the third inning. Max Kepler at the plate.
Right field. Raleigh's back out here for the third, and after the first couple of innings, pretty rough. I think the skipper's looking for him to give him a little bit of length, see if he can save the bullpen some.
In the air, right field. Tucker should have it. One away.
Almost a loud start to the inning on that first pitch. Man, he's going to want that one back, no doubt.
Verlander, a 6'5 righty, 40 years old now. He's the reigning American League Cy Young Award winner. And that'll get down for a base hit. Just kind of sliced that one into center.
Went up there looking to be aggressive and got something he could handle. That pretty much split the zone down the middle, and those are the ones where you got to make a pay.
In the air, right field. That puts the squeeze on that. Two down. Next to hit, Matt Walmer. Puts a bunt down. And foul ball. Out towards left center. McCormick trying to get there. He's got it. And that is out number three. Twins wind up stranding one. They lead 4-0. And welcome back. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Now at the plate, Chaz McCormick. Swing and a foul over the screen and back out of play. Lopez, a 6'4 righty. 225 pounds, and he was born in Venezuela.
Boog, it looks like somebody missed the swing sign. That's the first pitch this team's taken for a ball all game long.
And 1-2. Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. One gone here.
Came inside with that two-strike fastball nicely and just bunched him up on the inside part of the plate. Couldn't get around on it and catch it out front. Many times if you do, it's a foul ball. And you know, a lot of pitchers, they really don't like working inside with two strikes because they do not want to hit that batter. And when they've got him up against the ropes, got to figure out a way to put him away. Did a nice job right there.
Martin Maldonado in the box with two gone and takes a look at a called strike. Next pitch is popped up. Correa is there. Squeezes it. And the inning is over. 1-2-3 go the Astros. They're on the short end of a 4-0 score. All set for the start of the inning. And now for the Twins, Ryan Jeffers. And here it comes. Base knock, center field.
Well, clearly he was ready to hit right there. Everything was on time and fluid in that swing. Got a pitch he could get the barrel on and lined it into center for the knock. Those always feel good.
Out towards right center field. Tucker puts it away for the out. And there's one down. Number 47, the next Twin up to him. 1-for-2 in the game. He tripled and scored in the first. Now a high fly ball out to left center. McCormick brings it in with a nice running grab. Then at first, and next for Minnesota, Jorge Polanco. 1-for-2. In an RBI base hit back in the first. Lays down a bunt to the right side. They get the force, and that is that. One left for Minnesota, but they're in front 4-0. Welcome back. John Chomby and Chris Singleton with you. And leading off the bottom of the fourth, Jose Altuve. That one ripped. That's back there. And that ball is out of here. Jose Altuve will touch them all. His second homer of this series. It's 4-1. That was blasted.
Absolutely. No doubt off the bat. Well, that one got in the jet stream on a line drive. Saw the numbers on the backs of the jerseys of the outfielders, which is usually bad news. And all of a sudden, they're back in this ballgame.
Bound back our way, and that's out of play. And a pitch. Swing and a pop-up. Foul territory for the catcher. Jeffers takes it in for the out. And there's one down.
A couple of pitches and a quick out.
Alvarez batting for the second time. And that's strike one. And that one is lifted in the air. Walton sizing this one up. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's two away. Here's Kyle Tucker. That's in there. That's strike one. Swing.